Hello everyone. In this video, I am going to discuss about the problem of chronic pancreatitis, some of the basic understanding about this disease, what problems are faced by these patients, what are the tests and investigations to be done, and what are the treatment options. As the name suggests, chronic pancreatitis is a long-term inflammation of the pancreas. Pancreas is a digestive organ located in the upper part of your tummy, below the liver and just behind the stomach. The pancreas produces digestive enzymes that are needed for the digestion of food. It also produces insulin and other hormones that are needed for a good control of blood sugar levels. Chronic pancreatitis develops slowly over a period of time and leads to irreversible damage to the pancreatic tissue. The pancreas gets so much damaged that it becomes hard and shrunken. During this process, the duct of the pancreas gets strictured or narrowed at one or multiple places, especially near its opening within the intestine. There is also development of stones within the duct of pancreas. All these things causes blockage to the flow of pancreatic digestive juices into the intestine. Gradually, the whole of pancreatic duct gets dilated and filled with multiple stones. What problems or symptoms does this patient have? The hallmark symptom of chronic pancreatitis is chronic abdominal pain. The pain is intermittent initially, but over a period of time it becomes more frequent and may become constant. The pain is sharp and stabbing in the upper part of the tummy in between the navel and the chest. The pain may radiate to the back also. Pain is triggered by eating, especially eating high fat food. Pain on eating occurs because the pancreatic digestive juices that are secreted in response to your eating are unable to flow into the intestine and are entrapped within the pancreatic duct, causing increasing in the pressure of the pancreatic duct. Over a period of time, the pain becomes severe, constant and debilitating. This constant pain is because of entrapment of the nerves in the hard and inflamed pancreas. Many patients take daily dosage of oral painkiller medications and may also require frequent injectable painkillers to control their pain. The pain is many a time so debilitating that many such patients are unable to lead a normal life. When the pancreas doesn't work properly, it affects the body's ability to digest the food you eat. Hence, in some patients of chronic pancreatitis, they do not get the required nutrients from the food they eat, leading to malnutrition, weak bones, and vision loss. Foul-smelling, oily bowel movements and weight loss are also commonly seen in advanced chronic pancreatitis. This suggests that the amount of pancreatic tissue available for digestion is very less. Patients of chronic pancreatitis may also develop diabetes because of the depleting pancreatic tissue and may need insulin to control their blood sugar levels. What complications can occur in patients of chronic pancreatitis? Some of the patients of chronic pancreatitis develop jaundice. The lower part of the bile duct passes through the pancreas. And in some patients, when the pancreas becomes hard and shrunken, it compresses the bile duct. This leads to the blockage of the flow of bile from liver to the intestine, causing jaundice. Some patients also develop a condition called chronic pseudocyst because of the constant blockage and increased pressure within the pancreatic duct. A part of the lining of the pancreatic duct breaks. This leads to the leakage of pancreatic juice and damage to the surrounding tissue, ultimately leading to an infected cyst-like structure called pseudocyst. In some patients, there is development of a condition called portal vein thrombosis, in which there is clot formation inside the portal vein. The portal vein is located immediately behind the pancreas, and in some patients, the inflammation of pancreas causes direct damage to this portal vein. Portal vein thrombosis can lead to splenomegaly and vomiting of blood. What tests or investigations are needed for diagnosis and planning of treatment of chronic pancreatitis? Blood tests are not very useful in the diagnosis of chronic pancreatitis. Serum amylase levels are usually normal in most of the patients, except in few patients in which there is superadded acute pancreatitis. A CT scan gives the information about the shrunken pancreas and the dilatation of the duct of the pancreas. It also gives us the information whether there are stone formation within the pancreatic duct or not. In some patients, the stone formation is seen outside of the pancreatic duct, within the pancreatic tissue, or in the side branches of the main pancreatic duct. Information regarding the complications of chronic pancreatitis like portal vein thrombosis, splenomegaly, pseudocyst formation are also obtained from a CT scan, as these complications can change the line of treatment. Knowing about them is very important. An MRCP is a specialized MRI of the abdomen, which gives the details about the pancreatic duct dilatation, the size of the pancreatic duct, the number and size of the pancreatic duct stones, and the presence of stones in the side branches of the pancreatic duct. MRCP also gives the information about the dilatation of the bile duct and the narrowing of the bile duct at the lower end. All this information is very crucial in planning the treatment of chronic pancreatitis.